Hola, bienvenidos a Advantage. I'm Fabio, and today we are going to learn two irregular verbs that cause a lot of problems for many people. Why? Because in English, unfortunately, we only have one of them for just both. So what verb is that? It's the verb to know. So in Spanish, the verbs are saber and conocer. These are irregular verbs. They follow no pattern at all, and so all the forms are irregular. We are going to explore them today and learn the differences between these two important verbs. Are you ready for those? Let's take a look. Let's start with the beginning. How do you conjugate the verb saber? Very regular verb. This is the verb to know something. So, take a look. Yo sé. Tú sabes. Él, ella y usted sabe. Nosotros sabemos. Vosotros sabéis, ellos, ellas, ustedes saben. You see how irregular this verb is? The yo form follows absolutely no pattern. It's very important to stress out that this one has an accent on the form, se. Be careful, because if you forget the accent, it means something else. Let's take a look at the following verb. The verb conocer is a little bit trickier. But I want you to take a look at the O and what happened to this verb. Because in yo, you will have conozco, conoces, conoce, conocemos, conocéis, and conocen. The yo form is the only one that is tricky because you have to insert a Z in the conjugation. So it's easy, huh? Conozco. Do you remember how to say the other verb, saber? Good job, yo sé. So now we know how to say I know in Spanish, sé and conozco. So now that we know both, let's learn what is the real difference between both of them. Are you ready? All right, the verb saber means to know, but in what sense? It's to know something, to have information about something, okay? It's a little bit trickier because sometimes the verb saber is followed by an infinitive, in the case of you know how to do something. So for example, I know something and I know how to do something. So yo sé jugar fútbol means I know how to play soccer. Notice that the second verb is non-conjugated. ¿Sabes cocinar? If I ask you, do you know how to cook? You should be able to say, sí, yo sé cocinar. Conocer, on the other hand, it's a much trickier verb because it has nothing to do with information, but rather with acquaintances. So it's how familiar you are with a place, an object, or a person. Take a look at some of the examples. The verb conocer requires the personal a, which is a preposition where you refer that you have an or you know someone. For example, yo conozco a María Díaz. I know María. But notice, because Maria is a person, I would put a before, after the verb. However, if I ask you a masculine, about someone masculine, like conoces al nuevo profesor, notice that I would put al, because it's masculine. Do you know the new teacher? That is a good question. So this is what happens when we know or are acquainted with a place. We don't use that anymore. Conozco Madrid means I've been to Madrid. I know what city is like. And conoces el Museo del Prado? You know that museum? So notice at the very top, we require because it refers to knowing someone. And at the bottom, no because you are just knowing a place. Very simple, ¿verdad? Preguntas. I have questions for you. ¿Sabes dónde está Juan? If you notice the question here, I want to inquire where Juan is right now. That's information. So I will use saber. Good job. You can answer, sí, yo sé. Another question. ¿Saben dónde vive el profesor? Do you know where the teacher lives? That is a question about knowledge. Do you know where he lives? ¿Sabes el número de teléfono de tus padres? That's information. So that's why we continue using saber. ¿Sabes preparar enchiladas? This is a verb of action. Do you know how to make enchiladas? So notice that the very first verb would be the one that we answer. Are you ready to hear the answers? And the first one, ¿sabes dónde está Juan? Good. Sí, yo sé. ¿Saben ustedes dónde vive el profesor? Sí, sabemos dónde vive el profesor. I responded in nosotros form. ¿Sabes el número de teléfono de tus padres? Good. Sí, yo sé el número de teléfono de mis padres. And finally, ¿sabes preparar enchiladas? Good. You just simply answer, sí, yo sé. Or sí, yo sé preparar enchiladas. Okay? Good job. Okay, so I'm going to show you now questions with the verb conocer. So remember, in conocer, I'm going to ask you about acquaintances or if you know places. Are you ready? Good. ¿Conocen ustedes a la señora que trabaja en la cafetería? I'm asking about a particular person. That's what I am using, conocer. So basically, I'm asking you if you are acquainted with that person. ¿Quieres conocer Puerto Vallarta? I accompany this verb with another verb that we reviewed before. That's the verb querer. So I'm asking you a specific question about a place. So I want to ask you if you really want to go to Puerto Vallarta. Okay. Lastly, I'm going to ask you, ¿conoces al padre de tu mamá? This is a particular person I'm inquiring about. That's why we use this verb. Are you ready to respond to those questions? Let me take a look at the response for number one. ¿Conocen ustedes a la señora que trabaja en la cafetería? Sí, conocemos a la señora que trabaja. Yes, we know her. Dos, ¿quieres conocer Puerto Vallarta? Claro que sí, quiero conocer Puerto Vallarta. The second verb goes non-conjugated for this matter because we have two verbs. And lastly, ¿conoces al padre de tu mamá? Sí, yo conozco al padre de mi mamá. Good job, everybody. That's fantastic. I'll see you next time when we explore the world of verbs and particularly all the present tense in Spanish. Muchas gracias.